Welcome back to the channel. Today we're diving deep into the fascinating world of insect societies to explore a concept that connects biology, sociology, and evolution, genetic social evolution. This idea, beautifully detailed by Berthold Dobler and E.O. Wilson, sheds light on how insect colonies function as highly organized superorganisms. Stick around to uncover the secrets of how these tiny creatures achieve complex social structures through genetics and evolution. Let's start with the basics. Genetic social evolution refers to the way natural selection operates at multiple levels, from individual genes to entire colonies, to shape the behaviors we see in eusocial insects like ants, bees, and termites. Eusociality, or true sociality, is a key element here. It involves three main traits: cooperative care of young, division of labor between reproductive and non-reproductive castes, and overlapping generations within a colony. These traits allow insect colonies to function as a single, cohesive unit, almost like an organism made of many individuals. But how does this happen? How do genes and behaviors align to produce these incredible systems? That's where the concept of multi-level natural selection comes in. Multi-level selection theory proposes that evolution operates not only at the level of individual organisms, but also at the level of groups. For example, in an ant colony, the success of the group, not just the individual, drives evolutionary fitness. A well-coordinated colony with effective division of labor is more likely to survive and reproduce. Interestingly, this creates a balance of opposing forces. On one hand, there's competition between individuals within the colony. On the other, there's selection for cooperation at the group level. Over time, the benefits of cooperation outweigh the costs of individual competition, leading to the evolution of highly specialized roles. One of the most intriguing aspects of genetic social evolution is the concept of the eusociality threshold. Early ancestors of ants, bees, and termites likely started as solitary insects. Gradually, some developed rudimentary social behaviors like caring for their offspring communally. As these behaviors proved advantageous, they crossed a critical threshold, becoming fully eusocial. This transition wasn't easy. It required genetic changes that reinforced cooperation over individualism. One such change is the evolution of altruism. The selfless behaviors we see in worker ants or bees who sacrifice their own reproductive potential to support the colony. Of course, evolution is rarely a straight path. Countervailing forces, such as competition between colonies and environmental pressures, continuously shape the social structures of these insects. Once a species fully commits to eusociality, it often reaches what's called the point of no return. At this stage, the colony's survival depends entirely on its social structure. If the division of labor or cooperative care breaks down, the colony, and by extension the species, is at risk of collapse. This makes eusocial insects some of the most resilient yet vulnerable creatures on the planet. Their success lies in their unity, but that unity must remain intact for the colony to thrive. So, why should we care about genetic social evolution? For one, it helps us understand how cooperation can evolve in nature, even when it seems counterintuitive. It also has practical applications. Studying insect societies has inspired innovations in robotics, artificial intelligence, and even organizational management. In essence, these tiny creatures teach us big lessons about teamwork, adaptability, and the power of collective effort. That's all for today's journey into the world of genetic social evolution. If you found this as fascinating as I did, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon for more deep dives into the wonders of biology and sociology. Let's keep exploring together.